Say it with me, everybody. It's Demon Slayer season, baby. Yo, y'all probably thought your boy was done talking about Demon Slayer until season 2 dropped. We only got 2 days left, which is kind of nuts, honestly. But nah, your boy got one more in the chamber for you guys today. And the thing is, it's not even about season 2. It's about the brand new Demon Slayer Hinokami Chronicles game that is dropping soon. And honestly, I really wanted to talk about this sooner. I know I haven't made any like reaction videos over like the character reveals or any of the gameplay and stuff like that, but this is a game that I've definitely been keeping an eye on for a long time. Now, this new Demon Slayer game, which drops in like a week, if you're just hearing about this now, it's actually made by the same people that make the Naruto Storm series, which again, I am a very big fan of. I've always loved the style of the Storm series. The combat is really entertaining, it's really fun, and plus, like, yo, like the story events and the cutscenes and the quick time events, bro, like I'll always remember, like, that shit is so fire. So the same people, if you guys are familiar with those games, are making this brand new Demon Slayer game, which I said drops in like a week. And yo, I just wanted to talk about this today. You guys better get used to this. I'm probably gonna be talking about Demon Slayer a lot on the channel once season 2 drops and this game drops. So I'm just saying, get ready. But yeah, like I said, I really wanted to react to some of the trailers. The gameplay is looking like super nice. Obviously, it's very reminiscent of Storm's combat system, which honestly, I don't have a problem with. I know there's a lot of people saying like, oh, this is a Storm clone. Oh my God, it doesn't look any different. I mean, like, no shit, boy. It's made by the same people that made the Storm series. Why would they, you know, break away from the formula if it's working for them? You feel me? Even like the story aspect of the game is looking like extremely interesting. Like there's like these parts in the stories where it's just not like, you know, like little engagements and combat, you know, like it's actually like a little bit of like a free roam aspect. I think Storm 2 had this, and I really did enjoy that a lot, where you actually like get to move around places and talk to people. It's not just like, oh, you go into story mode and it's just like every single like event is just a battle, it's just a battle. But no, like we actually get to like explore stuff, you know, talk to people and whatnot, and actually like it kind of just flows through the story in like a pretty linear way. Also, guys, if you've been keeping up with this game, let me know in the comments down below, who do you think you're gonna main in the game, bro? Like, yo, who is gonna be a character that you're always gonna pick, bro? Honestly, if I'm being honest, man, I gotta go with my boy Rengoku. Ever since I saw this man's trailer, holy shit, this guy, yo, this boy Rengoku is the GOAT. I don't care what anybody says, dude. This dude looks so cool to play, like the ultimates. Oh my God, I haven't even talked about the ultimates and like how just how like good the art style looks, man. Like it just looks so identical to like how the actual anime looks. Like if honestly, if you showed them side to side like some of the ultimates and whatnot and like just some of the movesets that they use in the game, and then, you know, compare them to the anime, honestly, you can still tell the difference. But like, bro, like it's like Jesus, dude, like they did a really good job with the art style, the colors and everything, just how identical it is to the anime. And like, oh my God, I just know that boy Rengoku, I'm sorry, I gotta pick that man frame one. I guess my only gripe with the game, or I guess I really shouldn't say a gripe, I guess it's a concern about the game, is the roster. Now I know the roster is kind of a little bit of a controversial topic when we're talking about the Demon Slayer game, because it's not as, I feel like, expansive as a lot of people would want it to be. Now, it's not to say that there's not like the main characters and stuff. Like, of course, you got like Tanjiro, Nezuko, Zenitsu, Inosuke, you know, all the names that we know already. But you know, they have people on the roster, which this isn't a bad thing, by the way, I'm about to say, but like they have people on the roster that like, they didn't really do anything in the anime so far. Like they got motherfucking like Makomo in there. They got Murata in there. They got like Urokodokai. Like, I'm just like, I mean, it's fine. It's not like this is anything new to have characters that like don't really have that much of a presence in the anime to give them a moveset and whatnot and take up character slots. But I'm just saying that they don't have any demons. And you know, I know the anime or the game is called Demon Slayer, but you know, we still need to play some demons, my boy. I'm well aware that like Akaza and Enmu and Rui are in the game, like in the story mode, and you're gonna be able to fight against them, but like, so far, we don't see them as playable characters. Now, I don't know if it's gonna be like, oh, you gotta beat them first and then you'll unlock them eventually, which, you know, that'll be fine too. But like, if they actually don't bring them to the game, I feel like the game's roster will be definitely missing that, like, just a core aspect. Cause like, real quick, Future Ivory here, by the way, I'm actually editing the video right now. I did a little bit more research on like the whole demons and the rosters and stuff like that. And apparently Akaza and Rui are gonna be like free DLC updates, like once the game drops and stuff like that. So yeah, that's gonna be cool. Like I said, they have like all the main cast, and then they have like a like a parody version of everybody. I don't want to say like a parody version, I guess. Like, it's kind of like a school life version, like a little funny version of everybody, which is pretty interesting. But like, yo, dog, I want to play as Akaza, man. That dude is dope as fuck. But obviously, you know, there's still like a shit ton of characters and enemies that we haven't really experienced yet in the anime that might get added to the game later. Of course, you know, Tengen, and you know, I think the demon's name in season 2 is like Daki or stuff like that. You know, them being very prominent in season 2, I don't know if eventually they'll get added to the game. But like I said, I would really like to see a little bit more variety with the roster, because like, yo, you added Makomo and Murata, dude. Like, what the fuck did these people do? I mean, don't get it twisted. I like them a lot, but like, bruh. Like, I genuinely would be surprised if they didn't put any demons in the game. Like, even Muzan, man. Like, I feel like Muzan can still fit in the game right now. Like, it's not like he's fought anybody, like, of importance right now. But he's definitely, like, killed a few people. Like, we know that that man can, like, shapeshift and stuff like that. And, like, I know people's argument with this, but, like, oh, man. But, you know, like, obviously he hasn't fought anybody. You know, it's not like they've explored his moveset. It's not like Makomo and Sabito and Murata have had a moveset in the anime that we didn't know about. Like, obviously I feel like Cyber Connect 2 can make a moveset out of Muzan, just make him look dope, have some like purple and fucking red auras and shit like that. Easy clap, right? But honestly, that's just my take on the whole roster situation though. But honestly, dude, the game itself looks fire. Like, honestly, I have no complaints in terms of the presentation. Like I said, the art style looks amazing, the animation looks amazing, the just how identical it is and how close it is to the actual anime representation. It's just, it's crazy how close like the art style just looks. Like, just, that's actually insane. So yeah, this is definitely gonna be like a day one cop for me. Let me know if in the comments down below if you guys are thinking of buying this game as well. Also, I do want to make videos on it and or stream it, so let me know down in the comments below. You want me to stream this game? You want me to make videos on it, bro? Let me know. But yeah, everybody, this is something I wanted to talk about for a while. Like, I wish I would have made videos like while it was still like kind of like developing and whatnot. We're getting trailers and whatnot, but hey, better late than never, am I right? So yeah, everybody, that's gonna be it. Don't forget, make sure to leave in the comments down below. Let me know what you guys are thinking of this brand new Demon Slayer game. And of course, are you guys hyped for Demon Slayer season 2, bro? I know you are, bro. You don't even gotta answer that question. Also, make sure to subscribe. We're trying to hit that 200,000 subscribers together. And also, make sure to hit that like button before heading out. It really helps the boy out a lot. Nonetheless, though, it's been your boy Ivory, and I'm out. Peace.